Hi, I'm Professor Shiva Panchakshari. In this video, I'm going to discuss the divergence theorem. Divergence theorem is basically a mathematical theorem and this is used to convert a closed surface integral to a volume integral we know that a closed surface, let us say S, always encloses volume V. So whenever there is a closed surface in a discussion, that should always be associated with the volume enclosed by the surface. So in the engineering applications, we are going to see n number of applications in which the closed surface is related to the volume enclosed. Here also the divergence theorem relates a quantity evaluated over a closed surface to the same quantity which is associated with the volume. Let us write the divergence theorem. So the divergence theorem is given by closed surface integral of any vector A that is equal to volume integral of divergence of the same vector A. So this is the statement of divergence theorem in mathematics. Here, A is any vector field. A is any vector field which has partial derivatives. That means A is that vector which is capable of spreading in all the directions of the space. So this is a vector which can vary with all the three space variables, say x, y, z. If any quantity which can change with respect to x, y, z, the space variables, maybe with the different rates, then the quantity can definitely be explained with the help of divergence theorem. So keeping this divergence theorem equation, we can make the statement, mathematical interpretation of the divergence theorem, So this statement is completely the explanation of the equation one. Let us look into the left-hand side of this equation. On the left-hand side, there is an integration. The two closed surface integration. Integration of some vector A. What type of integration it is? So surface integration. So the variable should be ds, fine. But there is also a dot. That means the product is dot product. The dot product says that the quantity A is oriented in an arbitrary direction with respect to the direction of the space, let us say. the surface is having its own direction. Consider a surface, let us say S. We know that the direction of the surface is always normal to its own plane. If the quantity, let us say A, the vector A is acting in this direction, which forms a orientation of angle theta with respect to the surface, then the amount of A, vector A, that crosses the surface, that passes through the surface, is given by A cos theta. So another way, if there is a surface, yes, if the vector is acting parallel to the surface or tangential to the surface, the vector is not crossing the surface. That means the vector is not acting on the surface. That means no component of the vector A is interacting with the surface. So then the product of A dot ds is zero. And if the quantity A is completely normal or perpendicular to the surface, then the maximum value of A interacts with the surface or passes through the surface. So that's why we have to introduce the concept of direction or orientation of vector A with respect to the surface. That's why the angle of theta is playing a very vital role in this case. So wherever A is required, we introduce A cos theta along with the ds. So the combination of vector, the surface, and the orientation is given as the dot product between A and ds. So the dot ds indicates that normal component of vector A that is to be considered for that particular surface. The complete A will not interact with the surface. So I'm going to describe the left-hand side of the equation one as the integral of normal component of A. So we are integrating not A, it's normal component of A over a closed surface. So the integral of normal component of vector A or a vector field A over a closed surface, say S, is equal to. Now let us come to the right hand side. Right hand side is a volume integral. So integral of, so what you have to integrate here? Del dot A, nothing but divergence of A. Del dot represents the divergence of vector A. Integral of divergence of vector A. What type of integral? Volume. So integral of divergence of vector A throughout volume. Integration occupies the complete thing. So throughout volume, which volume? The volume enclosed by the surface S. V is the volume inside the surface S. So by introducing all these points, we can make the statement of the divergence theorem, which is going in this way. The integral of normal component of vector A, the integral of normal component of vector A over the integral of normal component of vector A over a closed surface is equal to integral of, on the right hand side also there is an integration, integral of divergence of the vector A. Divergence of the vector A throughout volume. It is a volume integration. Throughout volume. So which volume? Throughout volume enclosed by the closed surface. Enclosed by the closed surface. This makes the mathematical interpretation of the theorem. So based on this theorem, we shall try to write the same equation once again, the integral of, okay, the integral of normal component. So normal component is dot comes into picture. Normal component of vector A, A dot. Over a closed surface, the variable should be ds then. Over a closed surface, that is equal to integral of, again integral, what type of integral? Integral of divergence. Integral of divergence means del dot. Divergence of the vector A. Okay, the vector A. Throughout volume, volume is a scalar, so into dv. So volume integration means it's a practice to write it by triple integral. Volume, let us say V, enclosed by the surface. Which surface? We can also include S. Enclosed by the surface, S here. So this makes the complete statement of divergence theorem. But this divergence theorem is used in electromagnetics. So that means divergence theorem is applicable to any vector field that has partial derivatives. So in electromagnetics, we define this divergence theorem in terms of the vector electric flux density. Electric flux density D. Then we call this theorem as Gauss divergence theorem. So the divergence theorem defined in terms of Gauss vector, that is D vector. Because Gauss is the person who interpreted electric flux and flux density as applicable to electric field. So in terms of D, the Gauss divergence theorem becomes triple integral of divergence of D. This is the divergence theorem we can see in the literature of electromagnetics. Say equation 2. We can derive this equation in few steps starting from Gauss law. So we can prove this theorem starting from Gauss law. Since Gauss divergence theorem is the interest of our discussion, consider the Gauss law. Gauss law of electrostatics. Electrostatics. So what is that Gauss law of electrostatics? That is closed surface integral of electric flux density is equal to total charge inside the closed surface. So this Q is the total charge. It is not the point charge. It's any charge, but the total charge inside the closed surface, S. So according to this equation, we can recall the statement of the Gauss law, that is the total electric flux leaving a closed surface. So dot ds means normal component. That means D means electric flux density. D is the flux by area. Ds is the area. So flux by area into area, area cancelled, flux. So integration of flux means total flux. The total flux leaving any closed surface normally, perpendicularly, is always equal to the total charge enclosed by the surface or inside the surface. This is the statement of the Gauss law. Now, if the charge enclosed by the surface is a volume charge, because the surface here under consideration is quite enclosing quite larger volume. So that's why, let me introduce volume charge distribution in our discussion. Let rho v be the volume charge distribution. Let rho v be the volume charge distribution, volume charge density, volume charge density of the charge distribution, of the charge distribution within the closed surface, within the closed surface. Say yes. So we are taking volume charge distribution of density rho v inside the closed surface. Then I can represent the total charge within the closed surface as integral of rho v, volume integral of rho v. So it's a volume charge distribution. So now, using this equation in the previous step, let us give some number for them. So this is the equation 3, and the next one is 4. So here, using equation 4, in equation 3, we'll get some very good mathematical interpretation. That is the Gauss law, nothing but closed surface integration of D, which is equal to Qi on the right side, now to be replaced by rho v dv. Rho v dv. So the left hand side of this equation is the integration of D, right hand side is the volume charge density rho v. When you look at this equation, it looks like the both the sides are quite different. So it's very difficult to relate the left hand side to the right hand side unless you have a complete idea of the concept. So let us replace this rho v by an equivalent term in terms of D. I mean, let us use the Maxwell's equation here to have a meaningful equation. What is that Maxwell's equation? We have Maxwell's equation. What is this Maxwell's equation? Actually, it is point form of Gauss law itself. Point form of Gauss law is popularly known as Maxwell's equation. We have Maxwell's equation given by divergence of D is equal to rho v. This relation is termed as Maxwell's first equation. Basically, it is the Gauss law in differential form or point form. By using this equation in the previous one, we get the relation, the closed surface integral of D the closed surface integration of D is equal to the volume integration of rho v. In place of rho v, we shall write divergence of D dv. So this equation is already familiar to us, that is the divergence theorem. This is the divergence theorem, that is Gauss divergence theorem. Otherwise, divergence theorem in terms of the vector field D, electric flux density. So that is the proof of the divergence theorem. Now, let us understand the physical interpretation of this divergence theorem. So mathematically, this theorem relates surface integral to volume integration. Physically, conceptually, what this theorem is all about. If you look at the left-hand side of the Gauss divergence theorem, that is D dot ds. Dot ds, as I said, normal component that is passing through the closed surface. So if you have a closed surface, any quantity that is passing through the closed surface is indicated by dot ds. So what is passing through this closed surface? In this equation, it is D. D means electric flux density. If you take this product, D dot ds, D is electric flux density, nothing but flux by area. Ds means area. So both cancelled, we get the flux. Dot, say that normal component of flux, that means flux passing normally, perpendicularly through the surface. And integration gives the total sum, the total electric flux passing through a closed surface. So the physical interpretation of this term D dot ds is equal to the total electric flux passing through a closed surface S. Similarly, we can find similar terms in the literature, that is a closed surface integral of J dot ds. Let us say J means current density, current by area. That means this gives the total current passing through a closed surface. D dot ds is the total electric flux passing through a closed surface. So that is the physical interpretation or physical significance of the left-hand side. So the left-hand side of the divergence theorem signifies the amount of electric flux leaving a closed surface. That is equal to integral stands for sum. On the right-hand side, the volume integral stands for the sum, total. Sum of what? Divergence of D. Divergence of D means the electric flux diverging from a point. Because delta D, nothing but divergence of electric flux coming out of a point per unit volume. So if you take out delta D separately, we can understand that D means flux. D means flux by area, nothing but meter square. Del means it's having a quantity, having a dimension of 1 by meter, per meter. Because del is equal to dou by dou x, a cap x, dou by dou y, a cap y, dou by dou z, a cap z. In all the three, you are going to say numerator, there's an operator dou, denominator is the distance, dx, dy, or dz. So the unit of del, or dimension of del, is 1 by meter. So totally, delta d put together, flux per meter cube. Meter cube means volume. So okay, delta d, we can say that the flux diverging from a point per unit volume. Per unit volume. Why point? This is a differential form of the equation. del is dou by dou x. Dou by dou x is differential form. Differential form is the form of any equation in differential condition. That means very small condition. That's not a point. It's applicable to a point. So now, if we proceed one more step, del dot d multiplied by dv. So del dot d is flux by volume into volume will give flux. Del dot d into dv gives the flux diverging from a point. Flux diverging from one point. Flux diverging from one point. So now, if you go for integration of del dot d into dv, then we can say that the sum of flux diverging from every point within the volume, the total of sum of all the flux diverging, the sum of flux diverging from every point within the volume. So with this discussion, we can give the physical interpretation of divergence theorem. Let us write the equation once again. Here, that is going to be volume integral of del dot d into dv. Now let us give the physical interpretation. That is, the total integration gives total value. The total electric flux. The total electric flux leaving across the surface. Across the surface. Here, the leaving means it may be either going out or entering in. When we talk about positive charge, we always take it out. The flux going out of positive charge. The total electric flux leaving a closed surface. I don't want to introduce till that electric flux is leaving perpendicularly because it has to go perpendicularly to come out of the surface. The total electric flux leaving a closed surface is equal to, if the electric flux has to leave the closed surface, where it has to come from, is equal to sum of the electric flux. Sum of the electric flux. Where is that electric flux is coming from? Sum of the electric flux diverging means it is coming out. Diverging. Diverging from where? Diverging from every point. Sum of flux from every point in volume. Inside the volume. Which volume? That is enclosed by the closed surface. Enclosed by the closed surface. This is the physical interpretation or meaning of this divergence theorem. So in summary, if we have a closed surface, let us say S, then the electric flux, total electric flux passing through this closed surface is equal to the electric flux diverging, sum of the electric flux diverging from every point inside the volume. So we have to take point one by one, find the flux coming out of this, and you have to add, then that gives the total electric flux leaving the closed surface. That is the physical interpretation of Gauss divergence theorem. That's it. Thank you.